We hebben Sigrid gehad, we hebben Dodi gehad en is het tijd voor de derde aflevering van Female Virals met internationale superster Billie Eilish. Sorry, sorry. Toen ze 13 was, heeft ze samen met haar broer Fineas het lied Ocean Eyes geschreven. En op Soundcloud ging hij compleet viral. Billie's eerste album, When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go, komt 29 maart uit. En ik sprak Billie in Tivoli Vredenburg.
Hi Billie.
Hi.
How's the burrito?
The burritos are good. they were folded very weirdly, so I'm trying to...
Do you want me to fold it for you? Are you a burrito expert?
Dude. You don't even know. My love you. Someone from the label came out, who I love, who's like, I think of as a friend, but she actually does a job. she came out and I made her bring 6 cans of my beans and 5 packs of tortillas.
No, and also my boy, is there gonna be a song called My Beans?
Yes.
I should do that. That's fire. Mm-hmm. Do you want to do a shout out to the brand in case they want to send you free beans?
Rosarita. The vegetarian roof fried beans. Fire. Like, I don't even want to think about how much money overall I've spent on cans of beans.
Do you feel like you spend more money on beans than clothes?
Oh, you kidding me? Way more.
Honestly, beans over clothes any day.
The fuck? Yes.
Yeah. You grew up in Los Angeles, mm-hmm. and your parents were actors. Mm-hmm. It sounds really posh.
It's so not.
Yeah.
It's because hearing like my parents were actors, they're okay. No disrespect, but they weren't like famous actors or celebrities.
But they were working actors.
They were working actors. They were, and the thing is, like, my parents are really good actors, and that's what's annoying to me is that I feel like I see sometimes that are like, Billie's parents were actors, they brought her into the industry. I'm like, bro, they weren't successful though. Like, that sucks. And that's like, I feel like it makes me mad because I wanted them to be. I always was like, I don't know. I just, my parents are so good. Like, and they never got the recognition I felt like they deserved. And so it's annoying to me that people think, they just don't think about it. Yeah. My parents tried so hard, you know what I'm saying? Like, they worked really hard and like, just never really got. I mean, I don't know, because I feel bad. That feels like I'm being mean about it.
But no, you're not. It's like your parents, they are really talented, and sometimes talented people are not the people that are most successful, and that's just how the industry
works. That's how it is. It's annoying that people, like, sort of undergo, like, their hard work because they assume. I don't know. Shit's dumb. I love my parents, bro. They're fucking amazing. I love my parents.
But for you, do you still go back to the same house that you grew up in?
I still live there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How's that for you, just going through the roller coaster of like this and then just going home to your own home?
It's weird because, I mean, I've never even moved. Like, I grew up, I was like born in hospital, but born there.
Take me to you. Yeah.
Dude, I almost killed my mom when I was born. I was trying to get out.
You were a hard push.
Yeah. I was a hard push for sure. And I was all yellow when I came out. I don't even know. Shit was weird. I don't have to get into what I looked like when I was born, but, no, I mean, that's my childhood house. Like, I sleep in the same room that I, you know, slept with both of my parents when I was little. You know, I slept with both of them and my brother. We all slept in the same bed growing up, and then, of course, that changed, but same room, same house, same neighborhood that was super sketchy when I grew up, and it was always, like, you know, I couldn't really go out when it was dark because it wasn't safe outside and all that stuff. But now,
like, real Los Angeles, not the Los Angeles people think about. Daily life Los Angeles.
Daily life, yeah. Like, not a very good neighborhood when I was growing up. And it wasn't like I was going to die, but it was like, you know.
Be careful, be safe.
There was a lot of gunshots. There was a lot of, like, you know, not. Just a lot of. And it was fine. Like, that was normal to me because that's how I grew up. And, like, it's funny because I feel like people think if you're from LA, you're, like, rich and you live in Beverly Hills or something.
Especially when you say that as, like, an artist. You
know? Yeah.
If you're like, an artist, people think about Calabasas and stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Your parents are actors. Oh, you're from LA. I'm like, no.
No, this is the real life people LA where you work hard.
Yeah, exactly.
You try to go from, like, being an extra to, like, yeah.
Yeah. And, like, now my neighborhood is, like, popping. Like, there's all these hipsters around and it's fucking weird.
Gentrification.
I know. But, you know, it's actually cute now. There's all these little stores and shit. It's a little cute little neighborhood.
How do you notice that your life has changed in your old, like, house?
my life is not my life anymore. It's not who I was's life anymore. Mm. It's like, I don't know, sometimes I think about like the
Do you recognize yourself in old videos and stuff? Because you used to make, there's loads of videos of you. Yeah. I think it's really funny.
I'm
so tired.
Okay, that's it. Vines. I love Vines.
You know it's funny?
Vine is the best.
Vine is the best, but listen, like... if you, like, there's on YouTube, it's like, Billie Eilish, Fetus, Vines, or some shit. And then people are like, oh yeah, she started on Vine. No.
Made Vines just to make Vines, because they were fun.
I think I had, like, 6 followers. No, literally, I think I had 6 followers. Like nobody gave up, and nobody should have. Like there were some stupid shit.
They're funny now.
But they're funny now because they're so ridiculous. But like, it was only because Vine was huge and I was like 11.
You wanted to entertain. Just like you do now.
Yeah. To entertain. And
no, they're great. Thank you.
No, but for real, if myself then knew that like now, there's like compilation videos with like Billie Eilish Vines and there's like millions of views, which is so
crazy
embarrassing. I would.
You would have done
I would shoot through the roof if I knew any other shit was happening.
Do you remember the last time where you wanted to be famous? What age you were? When that was like the thing where you would dream of like being on a stage and singing songs.
All the time. Oh my god, it's all that I... But it wasn't like I want to be famous, it was more like...
You wanted to be an artist.
I wanted to be recognized for what I did, you know? Like, but that was kind of my whole life up until it happened. The only time that I really was like, I want to be famous, I only wanted to be famous so I could be closer to Justin Bieber.
I feel that on a spiritual level.
No, literally. That I was, like, planning on it. I was like, if I got famous, then I would be closer to meeting him.
Yeah.
And I realized that the other day, because I was, like, I had, like, a fever. I was home. I don't remember. This was, like, the end of last year. And I was sitting in my living room, and I was watching Believe.
The movie.
Yeah. And I just started crying, because I was like, oh, my God. The reason I wanted to be famous was to meet Justin Bieber.
That's like legit. That's like, I feel like I'm 24.
So but it was like a joke though.
No, but like, listen.
But that was so weird.
No, it's like every generation has like their thing. I had Nick Jonas, you had Justin Bieber. Mm-hmm. I feel like now people have Shawn Mendes. It's like this thing where you're like, oh, I want to be an actress or like a singer so I can meet my favorite person. They're going to see me and fall in love with me straight away.
Yeah.
Because that's how it goes. And then we're going to get married and I'm like super babies.
Yeah.
But the thing is, you were also talented and a good singer, so there you go.
I mean...
Have you met him?
No.
Do you ever want to?
No, because he... No, because I know he wouldn't care. Like, and then that's not like, oh, he wouldn't care, but it's just like...
You're one of the
fans he would...
like, what's your favorite Bieber song?
I can't answer that one. My favorite?
Yeah. The one that gets stuck in your head most.
Well, there's like sentimental. You know what? This is so stupid. I always like sidetrack about Justin Bieber.
There's a reason why I'm asking this. Don't worry. There's a reason.
But
why I'm
it's so annoying because I don't want to like look like a.
No, listen. Soft Billy. Soft Billy is important for people to understand.
I guess, but then everybody always talks about it, and I'm always such a loser. But it's all true.
But the reason why I'm asking is to get you out of your Justin Bieber misery of every single interview going about Justin. Is because do you feel like you are different as an artist because you know how it is to stand someone that hard?
Yeah, no, for sure. I think that's that's why you just asked that. I think it's like the only, or not the only reason, but I think it's a, like, the reason I talk about it so much because I as an artist and as this sort of whatever.
Just not Billie O'Connell, but like Billie Eilish as Billie Eilish.
Billie O'Connell.
No, but there's a difference.
There is a difference. Yeah. I mean, I think, but the reason I mention it a lot is, like, I think subconsciously it's me.
It's like someone sneaking in there. Yeah.
What the fuck am I saying? Wait, I was gonna say, wait. It's gonna come to me.
Okay.
Oh. As an artist, I think all I've been trying to do since any of this shit started happening to me is, like, be the artist that I would have wanted to be a fan of. And not, like, I'm my fan. More, like...
The experience of being a fan of an artist.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Not about the music, not about... whatever.
But, like, the relationship between artist and fan.
Exactly.
And, like, being seen by someone
exactly.
you love so much.
I want to be reachable to you. Like, I don't... I think a lot of it was, like, the reason I was so... I don't know. I just remember, like, especially, like, growing up with not a lot of money, I couldn't really... I never went to a Bieber concert. I couldn't even try to afford to go. And that's, like, that's not his problem, obviously. That's my problem. But, you know, it was, like, I remember looking up, like, meet and greets for my favorite artists, and it's, like, hella money.
Really expensive,
you
yeah.
know, like, there was a Bieber meet and greet. It was, like, $4,000 or something. I was, like, oh. I don't know how to describe it because...
But I feel like...
I think besides Bieber, like, forget about that whole subject we're talking about. Like, in general, I want to be reachable to, like, everyone. Not to, like, oh, you have to pay this much to come look at me from across a big, huge room.
Yeah.
You know, like, I... So, like, if there are people waiting outside for me or you know, whatever, I go up to them and I run up to them and I hug them all. Like... Or at least I try to, as much as possible without, like, it's not very healthy for everything.
Yeah, because you have to think about yourself as well. Because I've...
Yeah.
This is one thing that I talked about Dodie, the other artist I interviewed for the series, where I asked, do you feel responsible for the people waiting in line for you? Like, in the rain, in the cold, in the in the sun.
You can't.
How do you process that as a human? Like,
You can't.
Yeah.
And I feel like... I don't know, it's hard because... They're doing it for you... Which is beautiful and, like, so special. And, like, I think a lot of the time it's fun for them. Like,
it's part of the experience. You go to your artist, you wait in line for hours. Yeah.
With your friends, and it's like sometimes they come overnight and they, like, have a night. And it's like, as much as it looks like it's kind of miserable, I've done the miserable things. And, like, doing miserable shit with your best friends is actually really fun. Like, it is. And it's really memorable. And having an insane experience with your friends is also really memorable. And, you know, like, some of the girls, like, there are girls here that they travel around together. They've come to, like, fucking, like, 12 shows or some crazy shit.
Yeah.
And they all go together and they, like, fly to, like, all the different shows. And it's so, like, I want to do that. Like, that's so fun. Like,
yeah.
You know?
And do you miss that? Because I imagine
so
you being in line, that's not safe.
No.
Yeah.
No. No, and it sucks because it's like, all I did was go to shows. And be in the pit and, like, mosh and shit. Like, that's all. I did it alone a lot. I would literally, like, leave my friends. If we were at a festival or some shit, I'd leave my group. And I would always, you know, I would hop the little gate between general admission and VIP, right? Just, you know, my little ass.
Yeah.
And I would jump to the front and I would go all the way to the front, wherever it was craziest. And I would just mosh my head off, like, and not think about anything. And, like, that was, like, where I found happiness and, like, that was something that really hit me pretty hard when all this stuff started happening, because I can't do that anymore.
Yeah.
Like, I just can't. And, like, you know, I could wear a disguise. I'm like, well...
It's not the same.
I can't do it as me.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to, you know? So, I don't know. But it is what it is. Like, I can't complain, you know? It's just, like...
But those are things maybe people don't really think about when they want to do this. There's like a downside to it.
You don't think about shit if you want this shit.
Like, do you feel like you were prepared?
Because
this started when you were 13. It's the 2-year anniversary today of Bellyache.
Mm-hmm.
I think, 24th of February now.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you chose this, or do you think this just happened to you?
It was both. Because it wasn't like I was fighting it. Because I wasn't. This is what I always wanted. No, it's not. It's... Initially, I was like, this is what I want. And so, you know, everything I did was, like, I was saying yes to everything. It wasn't, like, no, I don't know how to put it. I really don't. I feel like everything I'm saying isn't actually true. Like...
Because it's complicated.
It's really complicated. Yeah. And also, like, you can't...
describe... It's also really out of your hand, maybe, sometimes.
It's I'm completely not in control. I'm just not. And it's, like, I think I deal with it really well. I think it looks like to people that I don't, because I'm a very open person, and if I'm feeling like shit, I'm gonna say it.
Yeah, because there's this thing on Spotify where if you look up Bear Your Friend, there's like a genius bit where they explain the lyrics, and then someone just wrote dead ass face. Like,
you and Anna.
This is like a second song about wanting to kill herself or dying. Let's keep an eye on her, okay? It's like weird that like people think that's all you are now, just like some big ball of darkness.
But I'm, like, not, though. And it's, like, I'm just taking my agony and things I go through and making it into art instead of, like...
holding it in all the
jumping
time.
Off a roof.
Yeah.
You know? And, like, that's... I don't know. It's just, like, I'm... I don't know. I love my job. I love it. And... but there are also parts of it that are, like, more miserable than you could possibly imagine. And make me want to quit, but no, though. That's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not that, though. There's moments like that. It's like if you're on your fucking period, and then everything seems like...
everybody's like, I just want to die, and you chuck that, and like, oh, this is never going to end.
That's what it's like.
Yeah.
There are parts of my career that feel like I'm on my period sometimes.
That's a great analogy.
Fucking gross, bro.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I love it. I really do. I'm so grateful and blessed.
The last question, because like the person from Lim was like, please wrap it up, we need to go. About your album, about writing, because I know there's a wall in your house that you write all your stuff on.
Oh my god, it's cold.
Oh, you breathe out? No.
Well, there's because this was choking me, so I can't swallow things right now. I have to take this off.
Just to eat the burrito.
No, literally, I had to take it off earlier when I was eating. Because I tried to swallow a piece of bread, gluten-free bread, thank you. Nastiest shit ever.
Yeah, almost died.
And I felt it stopped here. And then I was like this. I went like this to try to like let it go down. And then I felt it slowly go. Like so, but I felt it. It was like this big.
Yeah.
Going down.
Because your esophagus is like struggling for that.
I'm always choking myself.
Yeah, just like uteruses like on the periods. Ooh. Sassy. So your new album's coming out end of March. There's songs in there that I find really interesting that we don't have time to talk about, sadly. Mm. What's the song that you're most excited to release finally?
Ooh.
As like a writer going, these lyrics are so fire, I'm so proud. I high-fived Fineas like deadass. Yeah.
Shit, because all of them. Mm. But probably Zanny? No. Yeah. No. I love you.
Ah, so good. Why? Just like short, why?
I don't know. That song, I feel like I didn't even... I think with me and Fineas, like, can't even believe we wrote that song.
Mm.
Like...
is that the best feeling when a song just happens? Like, through you?
As that song just exorcism. Shot itself out of me and Fineas. Like, we just were... I can't even tell you. That song was like... but, dude, like, Zanny, I'm so hyped for. Bad Guy. Shit is... Max!
The label lady is like, yeah, that's fire, it's so good.
I love Ilo Milo to death. That is like, I make this face when I hear, I'm like, this shit is so cute. Listen Before I Go, I'm really excited for. It is hot as a motherfucking year.
Yeah, that we turn off the aircon first time. And then it's Wish You Were Gay, is that on the album?
Yeah.
Yeah. Somebody came out, the person, that's the story I find really interesting. The person you wrote it about, you wished were gay, and then they came out to you?
Yeah. I always sort of knew, but it never was happening, and it was making me, like, I just wanted him to get that shit. I knew it was, and it was a lot of, like, parents not being the right way towards him, and so I understood that completely, but... this was a person I just was like, I love this dude. Like, he's still a friend of mine. And, like, I don't know. He just...
it's an
anthem. I wanted him to, you know, I was like, come on, dude. That's not up to me.
No.
Of course not. But, no, I love him. I was, like, really happy for him that he finally could Live his truth.
Man, I want to talk to you so much about writing, but we don't have any time. Thank you so much, Billie, for
being
here. Thank you. Let me give you a gluten-free burrito bean hug.
Oh,
yeah. Thank you so much.
I stab you with this.
No, that's okay.
Beautiful.
Pain is beautiful.
It's so sad I didn't eat this one. It's just, I can't swallow. I'm going to try it. I'm going to find something to eat.
That should do it, right?
Yeah, that's it. My beans, my beans, my beans.